The defeat of clickbait and the comeback of quality content. It sounds like a cool movie title, but it can actually happen. This is Moco and my name is Maaike Delver. Mats, you set up Biblio, which is a content recommendation service. Could you tell us something about the business model in a few words?
Mm-hmm. So we're a SaaS business. We have software as a service, which means that we charge clients on a monthly basis, and we do it based on how much volume they have. So now that we're here, think about it a bit like a cell phone contract. You have a number of minutes and a number of texts. So a number of content items and a number of users. And essentially we sell packages based on how big your site is.
The news industry has been struggling with clicks versus quality ever since the beginning of the internet.
Yes.
Why haven't you gone into that business?
Well, it's a good question. It's a very, very good question. I think the unfortunate truth is that many news websites are still very addicted to the advertising model, which means that really at the end of the day, they have to generate more and more page views. And I say that's a game that Kim Kardashian always wins.
Because more and more journalistic publications are trying to change their business model from clicks to subscriptions, mm-hmm. like you. What do you think of that?
So I think that what I sort of call the pendulum is swinging back. If you look throughout the history of media, there has been a sort of swing between advertising funding and subscription actually many times. Mm-hmm. And I think for the last kind of 10 years, we've swung very much towards advertising. You know, in the beginning, all the newspaper sites online were funded by advertising. And what we're really seeing now is two things happening at the same time. First, because Facebook and Google are increasingly stealing all the advertising money online, that's a worse and worse business model. Yeah. I compare it a little bit to swimming in quicksand, right? You can swim very hard, but you might still drown. And on the other side, I think what services like Netflix and Spotify has meant is that consumers are actually increasingly ready to pay for subscriptions in digital media. So even if you go back 10 years, it was very difficult to actually get anybody to pay for anything online. But now there is a growing understanding because of models like Netflix and Spotify. So I think it's those two things kind of coming together at the same time.
So how do you know what you're not seeing? Because it's a pretty difficult question.
Yes. So this is no easy problem. But I guess that's part of what Biblio is really trying to help the partners we work with, is to make sure that they're not just recommending their most popular content to their users, but actually also look at those users' interests and maybe also actually try to look at where those users might be going. Mm-hmm. You know, am I trying to learn a new subject or am I trying to expand my knowledge and give them more and more content in that direction?
Thank you very much for the information you gave us, and great to have you here. If you would like to have more information about this topic or other technology topics, please visit our website mocomoments.com or subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you soon.